And I am back with the Science Viking Let's Play of Dark Souls. And I'm on the wrong window. Great first impression. Alright, we are going to learn how to level up in this part, but there's actually something else that I want to show you all first. If we go down here, if you look over here, there's a set of stairs. I didn't find these stairs until most of the way through my first playthrough. Down here is an NPC, actually, who we can talk to later, but right now she can't do anything for us. But if we go farther down, down even more stairs, please, if you're acrophobic, you may want to look away. Of course, if you're acrophobic, worse is coming. Alright, all the way down here, down, down, to Goblin Town. Sorry, couldn't resist. And wait for the elevator. In case you're wondering, I watched the first of the new Hobbit movies last night, so that's kind of on my mind. Alright, we could jump off there, but the stairs are over this way. I'm a little impatient, so let's sprint. And if it hasn't already, the ancient cops say, yep, these are the new Londo ruins. Remember this place, we'll be coming back here, but right now I'm going to do something unusual and talk to this guy.
Well, this is unusual. You haven't lost your head. And more importantly, you're free. How on earth... Well, I shouldn't pry. I'm Rickett of Vinheim. I was once an established smith. Look at me now. Can you believe it?
This NPC is important, actually. This is a good example of why you should talk to NPCs more than once.
Have you? Oh, no. Don't worry. I've no intention of escape. It's safe here. I can't bear the thought of going hollow out there. Although, I must admit, I've not much to occupy myself. How about this? I could forge your weapons, albeit with rather minimal tools. I'll show you what made me the best in Vinheim.
Okay, he can upgrade our equipment, which will matter later once we have Titanite shards, which are what we use to upgrade equipment. I'm actually here for something else. This guy sells basic sorceries and a basic sorcery catalyst. Why do I want basic sorceries and a basic sorcery catalyst? Because the Pyromancer actually has high enough intelligence to use basic magic and to use the weakest of sorceries, and I have a second attunement slot. So, we're going to grab the soul arrow spell. And I don't have enough souls for a catalyst, I need to go farm some souls in order to be able to afford a catalyst. So, I'm going to use the magic of video editing and say, I wish that I had more souls. Be right back. And I'm back. Wish granted, I now have about 2,200 souls. And I'm on the wrong window again. Alright, let's talk to this guy again.
Hello. What weapons have you brought? Go on, show me.
Unfortunately, since I don't have any Titanite, I can't get him to upgrade my equipment. Later, there will be a merchant that sells an unlimited amount of Titanite. Let's grab ourselves a Sorcerer's Catalyst.
Come back soon. Smithing helps soothe my nerves.
Now, the issue with the Sorcerer's Catalyst is... check the equipment. I only have two left-hand slots, and I don't want to completely give up either the Pyromancy Flame or the shield in order to equip the catalyst. So what I'm going to have to do is decide which one I want to use between fights. Soul of a Nameless Soldier. That's an item that you can use that immediately grants you souls. I didn't want to pick up any items off the ground while I was off camera. And back up out of the abyss. Though this is nowhere near as far down as we end up going. And back to Firelink Shrine. And now we actually have some bonfire related duties to attend to. Up here. Still no need to talk to this NPC yet. We'll be talking to her later. All the way up. And the rest of the bonfire. Two I have a second attunement slot, so I'm attuning the copy of Soul Armor. And now let's level up. Let's go over what the stats do. A simple way of checking what a stat does is to increase it by 1. This will tell you in blue everything that changed for each stat. The thing is, some stats don't do something every level. So for example, level up attunement once, nothing other than increasing all of our resistances. Level it up a second time, and we get a third attunement slot. So yeah, that's what attunement does. Endurance increases our stamina and our resistance to bleeding and our maximum equipment load. Vitality increases maximum health. Strength increases the damage of our weapon, which is the hand axe. Dexterity doesn't do anything right now, but it will when I get a weapon that scales with it. Resistance, all it really does is increase your resistance to damage a little bit more than leveling up at all would, and it increases your poison resistance. Intelligence doesn't seem to do anything, but what it does is it increases the damage of sorceries like Soul Arrow. In addition, most sorceries have a minimum intelligence stat that you need to have in order to use them. Faith is the same thing as intelligence, but for miracles rather than sorceries. I'm planning on making this character primarily a dexterity character, but right now I don't have any weapons whose damage increases with dexterity. So I'm going to give up increasing my weapon damage, and since I have enough souls to increase my level twice, I'm going to put one of those points into vitality so I have more health, and one of those points into endurance so that I have more stamina. I'm not going to be putting points into attunement for a while because it'll be a while before we can meet an NPC who sells pyromancers. Alright, confirm the reinforcements. And we have leveled up. And we've attuned magic. As for what it means to reverse hollowing, I'll get at that later. First, we've danced around enough. Let's talk to this guy.
Well, what do we have here? You must be a new arrival. Let me guess. Fate of the Undead, right? Well, you're not the first. But there's no salvation here. You'd have done better to rot in the Undead Asylum. But too late now. Well, since you're here, let me help you out. There are, actually, 2 Bells of Awakening. One's up above in the Undead Church. The other is far, far below. In the ruins at the base of Blight Town. Ring them both, and something happened. Brilliant, right? Not much to go on. But I have a feeling that won't stop you. So, off you go. It is why you came, isn't it? To this accursed land of the undead?
Alright, so that's our quest to find the 2 Bells of Awakening. One is high up, one is low down, and to ring them both. Before we do that, I'm going to show you around a few more things in Firelink Shrine. One of them is, I promised last time that I would tell you why you don't want to mess with skeletons. Well, I'm going to show you why you don't want to mess with skeletons. Here we have a skeleton. Ooh, a pair of skeletons. Ow! And they can cause bleeding. What happens is, if you end up with the bleeding status effect, you take a whole bunch of damage all at once. And I keep rolling off the stairs. Let's see how much damage my pyromancy does. Some, but you saw what it did to the asylum demon. You may have noticed that I have 10 uses of my Estus Flask instead of 5. That's because the Firelink Shrine bonfire is one of the special bonfires I mentioned before. See how little damage my axe is doing to these guys. I can kill them, but it's kind of hard. I would not recommend going through the graveyard your first time, especially if you're not a pyromancer and can't do this. Trust me, it will just get you killed. But since we've killed... Oh, crap! But we killed all the skeletons. That's the other thing, they're really good at looking innocuous and not actually fighting them. This should be the binoculars. Oh no, it's not. It's just a large soul with lost undead. Alright, I've pushed my luck enough. I'm gonna run out of fireballs pretty soon. So, hopefully you've seen why you really do not want to go anywhere near the graveyard until you're a bit tougher than this. I survive, but it is me. The second thing, and really the last thing I want to show you in Firelink Shrine, there's some loot here that we can find, but is this guy. Talk to him.
Hello there. I believe we are not acquainted. I am Petrus of Thoroland. Have you business with us? If not, I'd prefer to keep a distance, if possible.
Well, he's a bit of a jerk.
Hello there. I realize that I have requested that we retain our distance. But I also want you to know that it is not meant in ill will. Here, take this as a token of peace. No, go ahead. It's for you.
Copper coin.
Oh my.
And talk to
you again.
Time.
Oh, I know. How about this? I have to await my companions here anyway. So what if I were to teach you some miracles? Would that please you?
I'm gonna go with no.
That is a shame. Speak to me if you have a change of heart.
Yeah. That is your first miracle trainer. This character is not gonna bother with miracles since I have a starting faith of 9. But if you choose to be a miracle character, he's the guy you want to talk to in the beginning. Pillage this corpse for 3 humanity. Rest. No, I don't. 707. Early on, you pretty much want to level up every time you have the tools to do it. Having a higher soul level means that in co-op, it's harder to find people to summon to help you, and it's harder to be summoned to help other people. And in multiplayer, the people you get paired with are more dangerous. So, you don't necessarily want to level up all the time for the entire game, but right at the beginning, it's generally a good idea to level up. And we meet our first regular enemies, generic hollows. They are what we could become if we ever completely lose our humanity. Losing humanity comes from things like giving into despair or giving up on whatever gave your life meaning. They don't like fire burn. Yes, I did see the lootable corpse down there. I will go get it. Just not yet. And he's out of range. Probably should have switched it to... Probably should have actually put the sorcery catalyst for this. But he needs to die. That happens to him a lot. Where he'll just fall off the cliff. Block. Ow! Didn't block the whole combo. Most enemies can't manage a combo against a shield. If you hit an enemy while they're holding up a shield, it takes a whole bunch of your stamina. And if you run out of stamina while you're doing that, you'll be staggered. Also, if you look very closely, you can see that there's actually treasure over on that part of the bridge. It is actually reachable in a way, but I'm not going to go for it right now. I'll show you how to get that one later. Alright, let's keep heading up. After all, that's the way that they told us to go. Let's run over and grab this loot. Probably shouldn't be sprinting on a narrow ledge, but whatever. We have quite a few souls of a lost undead. I'm going to save those for something specific later. And an undead rat. Wait for it to hit me. You see a bar with a purple drop next to it appear on the screen when I got hit? When I got hit, that's a status effect. In this case, poison. When you're hit by an attack that causes a status effect, the meter will appear and fill up a little bit. It will then gradually drain as long as you're not being hit by an attack that causes a status effect. If the meter ever fills up completely, then you have the status effect, and you have to then wait for the meter to gradually decline in order for you to not have the status effect anymore. So let's quick kill this guy. Don't do a whole lot of damage with my axe, because the axe isn't really a great weapon. Starting to run out of fireballs. But this guy's really a fire bomb, and I don't really feel anything. and watch for the ambush. No matter how many times it happens. It took me a really long time to remember that that ambush was there and start not being caught by surprise. And we have a fog wall. But if you look closely, the fog wall disappears after we pass through it, so this isn't a boss room. But you only really know that it's not a boss fog after you've crossed it. Okay. Walk up here. Holy crap! Ah! Don't worry, we don't have to fight that thing yet. In fact, really, technically, we don't have to fight that thing ever. But given what we're going into, I think a change of equipment is warranted. Switching over to the Sorcerer's Catalyst, hitting C, and then hitting R to switch to Solar. And then getting shot. Not used to a character with this low intelligence actually using sorceries. Let me just grab a twig. Let's see. Grab a swig of that lovely Sunny D in the Estus flask. I know I'm not the first person to make that joke. Okay. Though I have said before that if I could have anything, I really wish I could have an Estus flask coffee mug. Like, not a coffee mug with a picture of an Estus flask on it. An actual, like, sculpted Estus flask that's made of, like, ceramic or something that I can drink coffee out of. I've always wanted to have one of those. Alright. Pillage this corpse, and we get a better shield. Let's switch over to using that better shield. How do you know that the shield is better? By hitting end. Okay, apparently not by hitting end. By hitting delete. Not backspace, delete. And it will show you the damage reduction percentages on the shield that you're looking at. The ones in blue are higher than the shield you currently have equipped. The ones in red are lower. It is slightly, looking from these stats, it is slightly heavier, but has higher resistance to everything except magic, and we aren't going to be fighting against magic today, and has higher stability. So let's equip it. What stability does is it determines how much damage the shield has to take before it will break your guard and cause you to stumble back. So a shield with high stability is always good. And we found a bonfire. Let's interact with this bonfire. Now I'm going to teach you kids about humanity. First, I'm going to grab one of these humanity items. I have quite a few of them. In case you're wondering, I gained one of them while I was grinding for souls. That's why I have 5 instead of 4. For those of you who have been counting. When I use it, it fully heals me, and it increases the meter next to my life bar by 1. That is my humanity value. Humanity does a couple of things. It increases your resistance to the status effect curse. Trust me, you don't want to be cursed, so resistance to curse is good. It also can be spent. It also increases your other resistances a little bit. One of its most useful functions is that having humanity in your actual humanity meter increases your item drop rate. And it also has the ability to, it can also be spent to do certain things. One of the things is it can be used to reverse your hollowing. Now I'm actually going to use a second humanity because I need it for something else too. So, now my humanity value is at 2. Rest at the bottom. First, I'm going to reverse my hollow. The way this works is you start the game hollowed. When you are hollowed, you cannot kindle bonfires. I'll explain what that is in a second. And you cannot summon other players or NPCs to help you fight. But you also cannot be invaded by other players or NPCs. When you are human, you can summon other players, you can kindle bonfires, and you can be invaded. But if you die, you go back to being hollowed. In addition, it costs 1 humanity to reverse your hollowing. That humanity is permanently gone. Now, you may notice, when we rested at this bonfire, we didn't regain any uses of the Estus flask because we already had 8, and this one only restores you up to 5. However, we rested the bonfire, kindled the bonfire, burning a second humanity, so we're down to only having none active and 3 total. and now we get 10 uses of the Estus Flask out. At the beginning of the game, you can only kindle a bonfire once to increase its Estus generation up to 10. So it starts at 5 and you can upgrade it to 10, and some bonfires come pre-upgraded. Later on, you'll get a way to offer more shenanigans and to upgrade it further. Of course, now that I'm no longer hollowed, I really don't want to die. Because if I die, I'll go back to the hollow. Now, I didn't level up, and there's kind of a reason for that. Let's head down here, kill this guy. There's also something called the Humanity Meter, which is, in certain areas, including this one, the Undead Burg, if you kill humanoid enemies, like these hollows we're currently fighting, then you will... it will fill up an invisible meter. When that meter reaches a certain value, you receive one humanity. So it's often worthwhile to just farm a little bit of humanity in areas like this. These guys will just keep their shields up forever. So you have to kind of lower yours and wait for them to attack you. Then you can raise your shield and interrupt their block. You can also use tab to try to parry. I'm going to try... Don't try this at home unless you're playing as a pretty tough character. That was not a parry. That was me blocking a reflex because I wasn't ready for it. I generally default to hitting shift when I think, oh crap, need to block. But that was a parry, and now I'm riposting and he's dropping his head off, and he's dead. Both you and your victim are invincible while you're in the process of performing a riposte, so enemies can't sneak up on you while you're murdering one of their friends. Come on, attack me. Put that shield down and attack me. Come on. Come on. You want to. Okay, screw this. That's the other way to deal with them. Their shields block a lot less magic than they block physical, so I'm just going to overwhelm them. So they don't feel like they're all day to tear. Also, if you were looking closely, you may have seen that he pulled an Estus flask out of his belt and was about to drink from it. Yes, some of these enemies can heal themselves. And... attacking them while they're locked into the healing animation never stops being fun. I mean, they'll do it to me all day, so it's really fun to do it. And that guy was hiding behind a bookshelf. Oh, it wasn't a bookshelf, it was hiding behind a shelf. And he's dead now, because he tried to sneak up on me. Now, let's talk to this guy. Don't kill him.
Well now, you seem to have your wits about you, hmm? Then you are a welcome customer. I trade for souls. Everything's for sale.
Alright. We only need to talk to him once. Purchase items. You can sell usable items. Repair powder, which can help keep our items from breaking. Orange guidance soapstone, which allows you to leave messages for other players. I'm gonna get this and probably leave some messages. He sells a key to open up an area that we actually are going to want to get into. And he sells various weapons. How do we compare these to what we currently have? By hitting delete. Delete will show us a couple of things. It'll show us the base damage that the weapon does. It will also show its required stats in terms of strength and dexterity. And it will show the letters under the words param bonus refer to how well it scales with a particular stat. So for example, the scimitar scales quite well with dexterity, but quite badly with strength, and we don't actually have enough dexterity to use it. I still want one, but I'll get one later. The hand axe scales better with strength than it does with dexterity. That's what we currently have. Now, we can do the same thing with armor. And it would be nice to have this set of chain armor, but we can't really afford all of it yet. What I actually want, though, is something that I mentioned in my brief blog about how to survive Dark Souls, is a bow. 1,000 souls. And then just some standard arrows. But a decent... let's just get 100. Spend the rest of our souls on them. We're going to want the residence key.
Thank you kindly.
Later. Now I'm going to show you how to get out of here. Go through here. Up. Over. And this looks like an ambush. I don't like that, so I'm gonna make you all fight here. And screw it. I am going to stop using Soul Arrow after a while because I'm not planning on putting points into intelligence for this character. So I'm just gonna use it in the short term because it's a nice long range attack and gives me some way of using my extra solar, my extra attunement slot. Grab the throwing knives. And down here. Okay, back up this way. But you know, I really do need to have that residence key because it's necessary to get a particular chest, which means I probably should have, which means I need to get more souls. Which means I probably shouldn't have forgotten that I have several Souls of a Lost Undead in my inventory that I just completely forgot to use. So, let's use Soul of a Nameless Soldier. That would be 800. And the others aren't quick slotted, so I'm actually going to go to the inventory and use them. So, dead. And I get 400. And now.
Oh, you. I hope you've brought plenty of.
I can quick buy the residence key. That's all that I'm gonna buy for
you. Oh, thank you.
I'm gonna switch back to Pyromancer Catalysts. Fireballs again. Switch back to my fireballs. And head back to the bonfire. Quick rest, top up on everything, and then advance through the Undead Burg to find more useful stuff. I am going to be running back to this bonfire and getting myself a healing circle, just powering through the boss, because there's some dangerous stuff between us and it, and I don't want to try everything at once. Sprint across this bridge before a guy throws fireballs at you, like that. Then, carefully, murder these guys. Plump. Yeah. Oh, I miss it, that ring. And he has a tiny sliver of health left, and now he doesn't. Hollow Soldier Shield. Not a bad shield, but I'm not going to be using it. And you see that my humanity value is now 1. That was due to the humanity meter. If you look carefully, when I killed one of those guys, there was a black haze that surrounded the normal getting souls animation. That black haze was when I received the addition, the extra humanity. Alright, walk up here. Once you've beaten the boss of an area, you can no longer receive humanity by killing the enemies in it. Open this chest, pillage it for 5 more black firebombs. Even though I started with 10, I'm still glad I have those 5. I'm going to need quite a few for what I have planned. Swap over to my fireballs. Great balls of fire. Hindsight, I actually probably should have been conservative, even though I have firebombs. What I'm about to do is going to be dangerous. Okay. Axe. Oh, ran out of stamina. And he's dead. Take a drink. No, I didn't need one after that. I've heard of various versions of the Dark Souls drinking game. My personal favorite involves take a drink every time you use your Estus flask. You will probably not survive if you don't do anything with alcohol. And you may notice Soul Arrow's home on the target a little bit. A nice convenient way of zapping those guys into oblivion. I picked up a short bow because the bow was actually going to be my long-range weapon for the majority of this Let's Play, but I figured I'd start off with Soul Arrows because with this character's starting stats, Soul Arrows are actually a slightly better option. Grab that Soul of the Lost Undead. I guess I really needed it. Put back to my shield. Run up this way. Have him fire right over my shoulder. If you don't kill that guy who's on top of the tower, he'll be shooting arrows at you from behind while you're fighting the next group of guys, and that's bad. You don't want that. as is. I can just pelt them with soul arrows just to slightly bypass their shield. So he moves too far away for me to be locked onto him partway through that. How do you like it when someone kills you while you're drinking from your Estus flask? Yeah, I thought you would. I don't like it either. Yes, you may notice that the soul arrow actually breaks his shield, but it also does... But he recovers his guard before you manage to get the second soul arrow. So you can't use this to break his shield and then exploit it. You're still going to do damage as if he had his shield up, no matter what. Quick open his chest. Gold pine resin. You can rub some of that on your blade to make it deal more damage. No jokes, please. Okay, good. No jokes. Alright. Gonna drink some Estus anyway, because what I'm about to do is quite dangerous. Got my fireball. In fact, since I pretty much can't block this guy's attacks, I may as well have my fireballs out, but I also have my black firebombs. This guy. You know what? Fuck this guy. That's why. And on instinct, I hit shift instead of through a fireball instead of a fireball. Ah, ow! This is why I started with black fireball. Because I hit him with five of them and a fireball, and he still isn't dead. I've already used up all the black fireballs I got from the chest, now I'm into using the ones that were part of my gift, and this isn't the only enemy you would want black firebombs against this early in the game. Note that I'm just constantly dodge rolling away from him. And I can breathe again now. Got myself a Titanite chunk. That's not really that impressive. The way it works is Titanite shards are used to upgrade the basic weapon, upgrade weapons at first until they reach a certain level, then you use large Titanite shards, then you use Titanite chunks. So I can't actually use the Titanite chunks. It will be a while before I can. But I can run over and pillage this corpse to get the blue tearstone ring. The blue tearstone ring is my first ring. They occupy a separate equipment slot. It's actually quite nice. It boosts defense when HP is low. This is pretty much... This just is a great way... It saves your life quite a bit. So when your health is most critical and you most need a little bit more defense, it gives you that. So attacks that would completely finish you off instead leave you with barely any health. And then you can heal yourself or run away or some combination of the two. Possibly while crying. Alright. I'm ready to take on the boss of this area. But frankly, I used up most of my resources getting to him, so I'm actually going to go back to the bonfire, heal, level up, and then come back. Be right. Hello, everyone. I'm back. And you may wonder why some things have changed, like that I'm hollowed rather than human, that I have 1,700 souls, and that I'm using a sword instead of an axe. Well, the answer to all those questions is I actually died a couple of times trying to fight the upcoming boss. So... I've made some changes to my equipment, and I decided I didn't want to show you guys every failed attempt as just one long string, so I'm going to edit my various failures to defeat each boss down to a montage, and put that at the end of the video so that you guys can laugh at me. Alright, that's me. Also, I decided to finally actually equip my bow, and I put a few points into dexterity and vitality to give me a slightly better chance of survival. Alright, let's grab my... Actually, I still want my shield for now. And let's pass through this farm. This is an actual boss farm, so you don't want to die. So, well, remember that, I guess. Up here are a pair of snipers with crossbows. If you don't kill them first, after the boss arrives, it's really hard to get a chance to kill them. And then you won't be... And then they'll just be pelting your back with arrows while you... fight the boss. No, you don't. What are you? Yes, you can knock enemies out of their healing damage. That's what they can do. It is glorious. Alright, we have people healing. Hop on the ladder. You can tap spacebar when you're on a ladder to slide down it rather than climbing down rung by rung. Let's run over here. Wait until the boss appears. Whoa, crap! And now sprint this way. Sprint for the lab. And then we'll climb up there. And at the top of the ladder, I'll be able to go there. So we move really fast, so it's already at the bottom of the ladder now. Lock onto it. Jump down as you go, pointing as fast as like you would in the silent one. Hit O to no longer be locked on. I'm not entirely sure what happened there. Get over the ladder. Climb up the ladder. This is a good example of what I was talking about before, where it might be advantageous for you to do something immediately, but you have to wait until the boss is in the right position for you to do it, or you won't get the opportunity. In this case, my previous attempt, I went straight for the ladder without baiting the boss away from the ladder. And I wasn't able to get the boss before killing him. So, leaving the boss away from the ladder, sometimes it'll still hit him. Chug, chug. Didn't lure the boss far enough away from the ladder, it seems. Dodge, leap. Sprint again. You make your attention this is actually hard for me. Or a bit of concentration. Wait, are you serious? Really? Viking, are you saying that Dark Souls is hard? Wow. Never would have thought. Disconnect and lock on. Sprint back here. You may now be starting to see why I kindled that bomb. Now I can hear what's going on with fireball. Took some damage there, but that was worth it actually, because it was quite a bit of damage to him. That was a bit less worth it. Shift, fireball, and I can breathe again. Dark Demon is dead. And I got a homeward bone and a humanity, in addition to a whole bunch of souls that I'll get in a second. That is a good time to call it for this part, so I'll see you again next time when we explore the undead church, find the first enemies that are actually likely to be a real threat, well, the first non-boss enemies that are likely to be a real threat, and meet probably the coolest NPC in the game. I love you all. See you next time. And I'm back. And you may notice I have slightly fewer souls. It's because I actually used my souls to level up. I put the points into dexterity and vitality. And let's go a little farther. I mainly wanted to get all my fireballs back. Of course, I also have black firebombs if I need them. Alright, look around this corner carefully, and you see those barrels at the top. Watch what happens when you start walking up the stairs. See what you get. And that happens. And it's really hard to avoid taking damage from them. Quick grab some healing. I want to save all of my fireballs for the boss. It's really fun to watch the enemy set up a really, really thorough... The difference is the Taurus demon is quite a bit more. Estus, please. If I die, I'm editing it. So you guys will only see the final version where I succeeded, and maybe a montage of me being angrier and angrier and angrier as I died, would be in the process of getting it. Okay. Oops, too late for a point of attack. No. I've never had that happen before. think it's time to stop being silly and start fighting in the normal. Or do it die. Bye. You might want to keep your distance from this guy because of how big his power is. Resist that instinct. Note that he jumped away from you. But because it's entirely possible, I were actually succeeding in doing it, to be too close to him for you to hit him. And I'm dead. See you next time.